Now we come today to the horse gate. And we're told in verse 28, from above the horse gate repaired the priests, everyone over against his house. Now, what does the horse gate speak of? Well, the horse was that which was ridden by a warrior. I wonder if you've ever noticed that in Scripture, that in Zechariah and Revelation, these symbolic horses are powers making war. There's the riding of the red horse of war. It speaks of that. Now, the Lord Jesus rode into Jerusalem on a little donkey. Now, that was the animal that kings rode on. And he wasn't meek because he rode on that animal. We think of it as being a meek, humble little animal today. But actually, kings rode on it in that day, especially if they were coming in peace. They only rode on a horse in time of war. And the horse is a symbol of that. Now, this speaks of the soldier service of the believer today. You will recall, Paul says to us, we're seated together in the heavenlies in Christ Jesus, in Ephesians. That's the great truth in the first part. But when you come to the second part of Ephesians, we're told you to walk worthy of this high calling wherewith you're called. So you got your head up in the heavenlies, but your feet are down here on the ground, and you're to walk. And not only that, it's in that section in the sixth chapter of Ephesians where he says, put on the whole armor of God. There's a battle to be fought, and there's a real battle to be fought, a spiritual battle. We're not fighting against flesh and blood, but against these spiritual forces. And today, though there is this movement, spiritual movement, interest in the Word of God, there are a great many adversaries. Very candidly, another verse that we are using a great deal today is Paul's verse to the Corinthians when he was in Ephesus. He says, a great door and effectual is open unto me, and there are many adversaries. Now, we found that on radio. We've never had such an open door as we've had on radio. And friends, I never realized that certain folk were my enemies till I began to give out the Word of God. And it's amazing that you'll be attacked today by certain men that ought to support the Word of God. They claim to be Christians. And you would think if they didn't have anything good to say, they wouldn't have anything bad to say. But they've been very critical of this radio ministry. May I say to you that there are many adversaries, and we need to put on the whole armor of God. And we're told to take the sword of the Spirit. That's the Word of God, and that's the only instrument we want to use today. But also, Paul said to a young preacher in 2 Timothy 2:3, he said to him, endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. Now, that speaks of the fact that you and I today, my friend, are going to have battles to fight as believers. And if you're not in a battle, my friend, apparently you're not standing for the Lord, because I tell you, the battle is waxing hot in many places. And if you take a stand for the Lord, somebody's going to try to cut you down. But we're to do that today, and many of God's believers are having a real struggle.